Hello friends, welcome back. And in today's sessions we are going to discuss about in prior sessions we already discussed about an array of object, and array of object. It means we can create an let's say you got a ABC is a class, and you want to create an array of an object. So what you will do, you will create an array of D equals to new ABC, and then you have to pass on the number of subscripts or like length of an array over there. Let's say you have n here. In this manner you can, it will create an array of object of n size, right? So now here in this case it becomes an array of object of n size over there. But now we need to we know one fact, that we have to say whenever you create any object ABCD equals to new ABC, so in this way an object will be generated. But it's a call to the constructor firstly, and then that object will be generated over there. Here in this case only the declaration of array will be there. So like to initialize array objects, we need to write the loop like this: for int I equals to 0, as array subscript starts with 0, I less than array length d dot length I plus plus. As you know that dot length is a property which returns the length of an array, and then every array object, let's say d of i equals to new ABC. Getting my point clear? So in this manner now every array object will be get initialized, right? Means like while creating an array of object, first of all you have to make a declaration like this: ABC array of d equal to new ABC of n. It's this statement creates an array of object of n size over here. If here you can, n can be user defined. Now by just declaring an array of objects, all objects are not initialized. So we need to set a loop over here, right from the 0 to len, and then every individual array object need to be initialized like this. This is what actually the concept of array of object. Now in today's sessions we'll be discussing about how to pass on object as an argument, right, as well as object as a return type. It means like, let's say if you f1 is a method, then you can pass on integer as an argument, float as an argument, or any string as an argument also, and you can return the integer also. So if a normal method can take a basic data type as an argument and as well as returning basic data type over there, so can we not write the method definition like this: ABC F1 ABC, right? So in this particular prototype, what you will find that F1 is a method, takes object as an argument, right, as well as returns object as well. Just study the like if you can write integer f1 integer in the similar manner. If I write abc f1 abc, so integer f1 integer means f1 is a method which takes integer and returns integer. So if any method can take any basic data type as an argument and return the Bessier type, then why not that method will take the object as an argument as well as return the object as well, right? This is the things what we are going to discuss in today's session, right? To understand how object can be like pass or as an argument and how object can be return type, let us think one thing that you have a my time class and you have like an object of a type. Let's say my time class consists the properties like hours, minutes and seconds, right? So this is one object of a my time class, and in the similar manner you have another object by the name of t2, right? Maybe you have different values for it. Now in third case, you have a t3 equals to you have a the third object will be initialized by default, right? Now my time having three objects t1, t2, t3 individually, but now you are planning to have a t3 equals to t1 plus t2, means you want to add the copy of exist copy of t1 and exist copy of t2 to assigned to the T3. Now you know one thing, that if C equal to AB is possible provided all ABC are the entire type of data, it's normal expressions over there. But as T1, T2 and T3, these are the objects, so you can't add objects directly, right? We can't add, because add is not a your t1, t2, t3, these are not the basic type of data, so you cannot add the object directly, because object is a variable of user defined type of data, and user defined type of data cannot be added directly. So in such situations you have to write a method like t3 equals to, that is okay, but t1 dot, you may write the method called as add a time in the class my time. You have to write the method called as add a time in the my time class, and then you need to pass on t2 as an argument over there. Now in this manner you can able to, what I said, you cannot able to directly add the two time objects, because objects are the variables of user defined type of data. So to perform that kind of operations, what you have to do, you have to write a method called as add time. It's a user defined method. So this one object, if you want to add the two objects and generate the third one, one object will give a call to that method, right? And the second object's copy will be passed on as an argument, and there you have to perform the addition with the two objects, and the objects are the same, the properties of the objects, and return that resultant value to assign to the T3, right? So this add time method, right? If you study the, if you want to write the method of add time, then it has to be like this: public my time, because it's going to return the object and object of my time type, and then the method name is add time, and it will take a object also as an argument, right? So this becomes the prototype of your my time, right? Add time method over there. It means what? A method can be accept object as an argument, as well as object can be also return type also. Let us study it by an example over there, right? Okay. So I'll be constructing a program for this. Add two time objects, 2 for the third resultant one, and import java lang.star, import java.util.star, and I'm having class my time. I'm going to define, now as you know, time class is already predefined in a Java library, so I'm not deliberately naming my class as a time, right? So as you know that every time class may have the properties like integer, hour, minute and second, right? This is the private data belongs to the MyTime class. Now to initialize this private data, I'm having a public constructor, right? Parameterizable. So whenever you give a you will initialize the constructor of a MyTime, then this dot r equals to r, this dot minute equals to minute, and this dot second equals to second. Right? Hope you understand this. Now the constructor definition is over. If you want to, you can add even the default constructor as well if required. But that is default constructor in Java. We don't need to write it over there. Default constructor is called as a do nothing constructor. So there is no point to add a default constructor over here because it will initialize the values to 0, 0. So here is a parameterized constructor. I can build a two string method to print the values of it. Override two string methods over there. Public string to string. Right, and return the value of return r, that is the value of this dot r plus minute, that is the value of this dot minute, and the seconds, that is the value of this dot second. Alright. Now I'm having a private data. That is r minus seconds. I'm having a default constructor, I'm having a parameterized constructor, and having the override to string method to print the copy of an object. Now it's time to define a method to perform the addition with the two objects. Right? Let's make a comment on this. This is private data, and then it's a default constructor. Here it's a parameterized constructor, and here it's a overrided constructor method, okay, to print the copy of an object, and then you have a method to add two time objects from the third resultant set one. For that I am writing a method like public my time, as my method is returning an object. So what type of data it is returning? My type of data, type of data. And there is add time is a method, and then it will take a one object is going to give a call to it, right? So let's say p is an object, which will receive that object as an argument, and here one object will give a call to that time, and p another object will get as an argument over there. But the resultant copy I need to initialize to the third one. So I will get the object my time, r equals to new my time. This is a resultant object, right? Then first of all, if you want to add hours, minutes and seconds, right? So what will you be adding firstly? The seconds. So this dot second, the seconds of the object which called to that called to this add time method, plus p dot second, right? Now this cumulatively, you know, means cumulatively, the object which called to that add time method and the object which passed on as an argument, their accumulations will be assigned to the r dot second. Hope you understand this. R dot second equals to this dot second plus p dot seconds. Because first of all we add the seconds, right? Let's example here in this case, you have first t1 object got the data 45 and t2 object got the data 45 again. So first of all, you have to add the 45 plus 45, 90 seconds, right? But 90 seconds means 1 minute and 30 seconds. So let's have a calculation like this. Okay, means first of all, we accumulate the seconds. Now, if these seconds are more than the 60 seconds, then obviously, in such situations, 1 minute has to carry to the minute over there. So, R dot minute, resultant minute equals to total of seconds, what we accumulation, divided by 60. Hope you understand this. If you divide by 60, you will get the, means if the total number of seconds are more than 60, then the 1 minute will be carryover. This is the carryover logic I write over here, right? After that, the remaining seconds, mod equals to second, remaining seconds will be assigned to the second again, right? Then R dot minute is carryover minute plus this dot minute plus P dot minute. Now here in this case, again, the carry, if that accumulation of seconds may be carry extra minute in it, plus the current object's minute plus the P object's minute over there. Again, the same thing, R dot R equals to R dot cumulative minutes by 60, if any carry over extra R will be there, and then R dot minute mod equals to 60. The remaining minutes will be assigned to the R dot minute, and then R dot R plus equals to this dot R plus P dot R, right? And then in this manner, after adding the seconds, after adding the minutes, and after adding the R, the resultant object that is written, resultant object R will be written, right? So add time is a method which takes an object as an argument and return the object as well. So it is returning not integer, but it is returning an object. It is not taking any argument as a integer or something, it is taking a object as an argument, right? So this add time is an example of how we can pass on object as an argument, at the same time how we can return the object as an argument as well, right? Now here the definition of my time will be over. Now you build a test my time class, right? And here you can accept the data of from the user, or otherwise you can, like, let's say create the three time objects, my time t1 equals to new my time, right? Let's say deliberately 2 hours 54 minutes or and 45 seconds you are adding, and the second object of my time will be maybe 3 hours, maybe here 45 minutes, and here 55 seconds, right? And now I want to create a resultant object, means T3, right? It's a default one now, and because I want to add the two exist time objects, and their additive copy will be assigned to the resultant one. So as I said, T3 equals to T1 plus T2 would be possible, because T1, T2 and T3 are not the basic data types over there, because to perform arithmetic operation is only possible with the basic data types, not with the user defined type over there. So in such situations, I have to, as T3 equal to T1 plus T2, these expressions I can't write. So what I can do, T3 equal to T1 dot, I'll give a call to the add time and pass on T2 as an argument over here, right? Because I'll add the expression T3 equals to T1 plus 2. Perform this T3 equal to T1 plus T2. I can't write this expression directly because I am dealing with the objects. And object is a user defined type of data. So you cannot add the user defined type of data directly. So I'm giving call to the add time method, which is available in a my time class. And add time method gets the, will be here, the value of T2 will be passed on to P, right? And R is holding the copy of T3, and this is actually referring to the copy of T1, right? Because T1 is giving call to the add time method, so this object reference is referring to T1, and P is referring to T2, and R is referring to T3. Right? Now, let us check it out. Like, okay, what is the result? System dot out dot println. Okay. T1 object. Okay, T1 object. If you just print the copy of T1, so it will print the copy of T1 only the 2 hours, 54 minutes and 45 seconds, because if you refer an object directly in the system.println, it gives the call to local to string method and convert that all the properties into the string, right? As I already explained you, and then I'm planning to print the copy of T2 object. Right. And then I'll be printing the copy of T3 object. Right. Now, if you can successfully able to add the copy of two objects, and then generate the third resulted one, then you got the success over here. We successfully able to pass on object as an argument as well as return object as well. Right. Let us test this code. Now we have to test this code by test my child, and okay, in this case we have to go with the Java test and save this code. Save test my child.java, and we need to switch to the CMD. And decoding Java test Java. So paste my child dot java. The code get successfully compiled, and then after that java test my child. Right. What the result you are getting, that the copy of T1 means 2 hours 45 minutes 54 minutes and 45 seconds. Copy of T2 object is 3 hours 45 minutes and 55 seconds. And when you accumulate the copy of this thing, let's say first of all you have to add the seconds, 45 plus 55, that is 100 seconds over there, but you cannot write 100 seconds. In 100 seconds 1 minute is there and 40 seconds, so 40 remaining seconds will be remained over here, and 1 minute has to be carry over. So 1 minute we carry over here, then 54 plus 45 is actually 99, but whenever you carry your 1 over here again, it's become 100 minutes, and 100 minutes means you have to carry 1 over here, 1 in the R, and remaining 40 means 40 seconds, 40 minutes, and 1 carry in the R is 2 plus 3, 5 plus 1 carry R, 6. So resultant value will be 6 hours 40 seconds and 40 minutes and 40 seconds. Hope you understand this, right? So in this manner, what we need to understand firstly, where you can even able to generate the method which can be take object as an argument. Not only one, you can even able to pass on the multiple objects also as an argument. But as you know that method's return type will be the only one. So method can be accept object as an argument, as well as method can be written the object as well. So this is the thing what we have to prove. We start our discussions with the array of object. What is array of object? Yes, just like a normally we form an array of integers, right? We form an array of integers. Why not we form an array of objects as well? So yes, it is absolutely possible to create an array of object also. But while creating an array of objects, just by declaration it won't be over. You have to initialize the copy of each individual object like this, right? And the second thing what we discussed, that just like to any method we can pass on any basic data type and return any basic data type. In a similar manner, we can even able to pass on the object as an argument as well as object as the return type as well, right? So and then to prove that particular point, we had discussed the example of a MyType as well. Hope you understand the things well, right? Thank you.